There's a great deal of interest in the next generation of IEEE 802.11 standard, known as 802.11BE. It's also known as the extremely high throughput standard, or from a certification point of view from the Wi-Fi Alliance, known as Wi-Fi 7. Because it is focused on throughput, some of the most interesting new features to look at do have to do with throughput. In Wi-Fi 7 operates in the 6 gigahertz band, which is shown in this slide, is made up of, at least in the United States and in many regions, quite a lot of spectrum, as much as a gigahertz or more of spectrum. And because it has so much spectrum available, it does allow for extremely wide channels compared to previous generations of Wi-Fi, up to 320 megahertz. In addition to these wide channels, it has support for a new higher modulation known as 4096 QAM or 4K QAM. And these things together lead to, as the standard's named, extremely high throughput. So we can start by just taking a look at an example of this high throughput. What I'm showing here is the Octobox testbed with two Wi-Fi 7 devices communicating with each other. If we look down here at the bottom, we can see that the bandwidth is in fact 320 megahertz. We're getting 320 megahertz channel. And in both the transmit and the receive direction, you can see that we have MCS13, that's the 4K QAM modulation. The data rate associated with four stream 320 megahertz bandwidth 4K QAM is, as shown here, 11.5 gigabits per second. And that is the physical layer rate that we're seeing. And if we then look at the throughput that we're achieving, you can see we're achieving nearly 8 gigabits per second over this extremely high throughput Wi-Fi link. Another feature of great interest in Wi-Fi 7 is what's known as multi-link operation, or MLO. MLO is very similar to what is known as carrier aggregation in cellular networks. Previous generations of Wi-Fi, it was only possible for a single device to use any given band at a time. So the device could be operating in the 2.4 gigahertz band, could be operating in the 5 gigahertz band, or could be operating in the 6 gigahertz band. With multi-link operation, devices can now aggregate bands together and therefore achieve any number of things. But one of those important things is to aggregate bandwidth. So to get higher throughput, again, the extremely high throughput amendment to this specification. To give a sense of how multi-link operation works, I'm going to show three different things. They'll go in order. So first, what I'm showing here is a device operating using only the 5 gigahertz band. If we look again down here at the bottom of our display, we can see that we are operating at 160 megahertz. And from the name, you can see the underscore 5 here indicates that we're operating in the 5 gigahertz band. So we're operating at 160 megahertz in the 5 gigahertz band, still getting MCS 13, so 4K QAM. And if we look at the amount of throughput that we've got, we're getting about 4.8 gigabits per second of throughput. For the second stage in this part of the demo, I'm showing the same device, but now connected on the 6 gigahertz band. You can see over here, the little underscore 6 showing that we're in the 6 gigahertz band. Again, if we slide to the bottom of the display, you can see that we're operating at 160 in the 6 gigahertz band, again at MCS 13, so 4K QAM. And in this case, we're getting about 4.4 gigabits per second of throughput over this link. And now for the third and final part of this demo, I'm going to bring together these two links into a single multi-link. to increase the overall throughput. So if we look now again down here at our bandwidth, we can see that in fact this time we have both the 5 gigahertz and the 6 gigahertz links active, both at 160 megahertz. All the traffic is being handled at MCS 13, so at the highest data rate. And now if we look at the total throughput, we can see that we have used MLO to increase the total data throughput for this device to very close to 8 gigabits per second.